Hi, everybody. This is Jennifer with Choice Slides. And in today's Q&A, I'm going to be answering a customer who had a question about changing the background in a pre-built slide style. Now, he happened to have been looking at this slide style and he didn't like the white, but he hadn't actually applied the style yet. He just wanted to know if you could change the background. And the answer is always yes. In any program, you can always change the background of any pre-built slide style. The real question is whether it's considered a background in that slide style, or is it just the very bottom layer in the layer list? So I have both Photopia and ProShow open with the same slide style, and I want to show you this slide style. If you look at it in ProShow, you don't see anything in the layer list. It's actually just they've changed the background to white. So in this case, you can either just change the color or you could add an image file either here for the background or just drop it in as a lower layer. In Photopia, you can see that there's actually in the layer list, you can see that custom background. You could turn that off and then it goes to the global background, which is black. You could also just simply add another layer as the background. And in both programs, you can either add that layer simply as the very most bottom layer of your layer list, or you can actually add an image file in the background. Now, both programs allow you to choose what the background will be per slide. You can either use the default, or you can set a color, or you can even add an image file. If you don't want to use the background setting, you can always just add a new image file and simply drop it down to the bottom of your layer list. Now, one difference in between ProShow and Photopia is that Photopia also allows you to use video files as a global background. So in short, the answer is yes. Even though these are pre-built and pre-designed, you can always change the background of a pre-built slide style either through the background settings itself or by simply dropping a new layer at the very bottom of your layer list.